a good way to start the season off against, you know, a MAC opponent today, a 0-0 tie against Fairfield, you know, a team that was picked second overall in the MAC. Talk about the game that you saw.
Well, every time we play Fairfield, it's always a bloody game. They're our biggest rivals in the MAC, so we always come out to beat them, and we know it's going to be a good, like, tough game. So I think we brought everything we had to the table today, and everyone gave it their all. We worked hard. We had a lot of chances. We outshot them 21-13, which was an improvement for us. So I'm just, like, really proud of the girls.
Like you said, it was a great effort out here. You know, you had your opportunities to score. Coach said in the huddle there, you guys play like this, you know, you're going to be a tough team to beat. What do you have to do to bring that, you know, attitude every game that you guys play now for the rest of the season?
I mean, we just got to get fired up. We got to make sure we come out with the same intensity, and our pre-warm-up and our, like, pre-game speeches need to be on point. We all need to be focused. And if we do that, we come and we play every game like we just did, there's no doubt in my mind we'll make the tournament. We'll be in the championship final.
Next weekend, you host two more MAC games against St. Peter's and Manhattan, two teams that you can't overlook. Talk about what you have coming up in the next weekend.
Well, St. Peter's has always been lower in the MAC, but it's always been a very competitive game. Those girls have a lot of heart, so we got to make sure we're on fire next weekend. And then Manhattan also is another big rival in the MAC for us. You know, they're only 20 minutes down the road. We know a lot of the girls, so it's going to be another really intense, competitive game. But if we play like we did today, we'll definitely come out with two wins next weekend.
Well, good luck. This is your first MAC contest, and it was a very hard, tough-fought game. You guys both battled. Talk about what you saw in the game today.
Well, I thought both teams played really well. We both fought really hard. We both wanted it. And it's just unfortunate that we couldn't get away with the win today.
You guys had a 21-13 shot advantage in the game, and, you know, you had a couple scoring opportunities. Coach mentioned in the post-game speech that you guys bring this kind of mentality to every game coming up in the MAC season. You guys are going to do very well. Diane answered the question, what do you think, what do you guys need to do to be able to bring that mentality every game?
I think we just need to do what we keep doing. We are very disciplined. We just have to, like, keep working hard, work hard for each other, for the team. And if we come away like this, I feel like we have no problem winning the MAC.
And then the last question is, again, this will be your first opportunity to play two more local MAC rivals, St. Peter's and Manhattan. And it's on this home field next weekend. Talk about the two games coming up against, you know, more MAC rivals.
Well, I never really seen them play, but I heard they're good teams. I'm really excited to play, and I think we can pull away with the win with both games.
Great, Coach. Obviously, you want to come away with a victory, but, you know, playing 110 minutes in a scoreless tie in your first conference game against a team like Fairfield, you know, you have to come away with a little bit of satisfaction that at least you got 1 point.
Oh, yeah. I mean, obviously, we're very happy with how we played today. I think we really were very aggressive and created a lot of chances. I mean, I think we outshot them 2-1, basically. We did everything that we wanted to do. We're just still waiting for that one break, you know, that will get into the back of the net for us. But, you know, we saw a lot of positives today that we're very happy about. And, you know, we kind of spoke to him afterwards that, you know, we can't just rest on this. This is how we have to play. And if we play like this week in and week out, we're going to be up at the top of the conference at the end of the day.
Got some good stops from your freshman goalkeeper and Trista, and you also had some good opportunities there. You know, it was a very evenly played match throughout the first 90 minutes, and then you kind of, you know, poured it on a little bit in overtime. Like you said, if you keep this up, you guys are going to do just as well as, if not better, all the entire season. Talk about what you need to do to keep this attitude.
Well, one is our mentality in training. I mean, we have to be willing to go out and train at a high level and push ourselves, and that's something that we kind of talked about after the LIU game, because we came out a little bit flat, and we've really trained well the last week and a half, and we have players pushing each other. I mean, even, like, you know, you talked about Tristan, who played a fantastic game, but, you know, a lot of that credit's got to go to Jackie as well, who, you know, unfortunately didn't get to play, but has been pushing and is right there, and that helps us. You know, the better we can compete in training, the better we're going to be when we step on the field.
Next weekend, two more home games against Manhattan and St. Peter's. Again, they're local rivals, and the girls will be fired up for that game. Talk about those two games, you know, and the advantage of playing here at home.
Well, I mean, obviously, you know, we like to play on our own field, and especially, you know, you take, you know, a team like St. Peter's who plays on a grass field, so hopefully that will help us a little bit. You know, but the other part of it is those two teams have vastly improved. I mean, St. Peter's had a lot of good results, and we scouted them once or twice, and we know that, you know, they're not the St. Peter's of, you know, 4 or 5 years ago. It's a team that can go and win a lot of games, and, you know, we can't allow this game to be our high point. This has to be the starting point. And, you know, for us, we have a great opportunity to go into these next two games and, you know, find a way to pull out two wins and put ourselves in a great position going down the line. And, you know, but we have to take it one step at a time. That's going to be St. Peter's on Friday.
Like you said, next game is right here at Mazzella Field at 3 p.m. against St. Peter's. Coach, good luck, and we'll see you then.
Thanks.